إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له جل عن الشبيه والمثيل والند والنظير، وأشهد أن محمد.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we thank Him, we seek His guidance, His mercy, His forgiveness. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses with iman and guidance, then no one can misguide. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves to go astray due to the person turning away from Allah, His signs and His guidance, then no one can guide. And we testify and we bear witness that no one has the right to be worshipped except our Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final messenger and his servant. To proceed, in less than a week's time, inshallah ta'ala, there will be a new year. And of course, as Muslims, we have our own calendar year, the Hijri year. So our new year was around 3 to 4 months ago. However, the time and the place that we live and the current calendar that we follow, we have a new year to come. And this could be a good chance and opportunity from time to time that we sit down and we reflect and we plan for our futures. We ask ourselves, what have I left behind for my akhirah? What legacies am I working hard towards? What are my plans for myself, my family, my deen, my children, my community, my society? And what efforts am I putting towards achieving these goals? As Muslims, brothers, we should all be planners. We should all be visionary people. We should all be concerned about our development and the development of our families and our communities. We should always have constant, noble goals, targets, aims and objectives. And we should always work hard and have strong will and determination to achieve our goals. This is from our Islamic teaching, to promote being visionary, hardworking, positive, optimistic, and good planners. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبْ إِذَا عَمَلَ أَحَدَكُمْ عَمَلَ أَيُّتْقِنَهُ. Indeed, Allah loves when someone does an action that he does it with perfection. He does it with beauty. He does it with effort. This is the teachings of our religion. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اعملوا فَكُلُّ مُنَسِّرٌ لِمَا خُلِقَ لَهُ. Work, do the actions. Each one of you will be guided to what he is best for. One of you will become a doctor. One of you will become a leader. One of you will become a scholar. Each one of you will be guided to his position in society, to what is best for him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed Bani Adam. And on top of that, he blessed individually each one of us to have certain blessings, talents, skills that no one else has. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala favored Bani Adam with the aql, وعلم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. He has taught man that which he did not know. So ilm, knowledge and learning is something exclusive as an attribute to humans that Allah Azza wa Jal gave to them and no one else. And this is why we have created civilizations, inventions, technology. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. He swears by the time, and all of mankind is in loss. Why are all of mankind in loss? Except the believers and those who do righteous good deeds and cooperate in patience and the truth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that we have made insan the best creation. And then we have degraded them to become the worst of the worst. Again, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, except those who believe. So when we have aql and iman, and we use the two for the sake of Allah, we can achieve so much. But when we have aql, and we have blessings from Allah, but no iman, and we do not use the blessings for the sake of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we become worse than any other creation. We become worse than anyone else. So we need to return back to studying the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You will be surprised that he was the most visionary person sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the most hard-working person. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I want to be on the Day of Judgment the Nabi, the Prophet that has the most followers on the Day of Judgment. This vision of his led him to give da'wah every single day, led him to call people to La ilaha illallah, led him to never give up. When the people of Ta'if, when the people of Quraysh, when the mushrikeen abused him, abused his followers, killed some of the followers, made them exiled, made the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam exiled, 10 years of striving and hard work, and in response they rejected him. And likewise the Anbiya. But his vision led him to continue. His vision led him to have hope. His daughter Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, she will cry in this year that is called Aam al-Huzn, the year of sadness. So many things happen. Her mother passed away, Khadija. Some of the Muslimin are being oppressed, exiled. Quraysh has increased their hatred and attacks against the Muslimin at that same year. The beloved uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. No more political protection for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But he said to Fatima, do not cry. He wiped the tears of her face. He was optimistic and hopeful. The light will come, the victory will come. And that same year he went to Ta'if and called people to Islam. He went to that young child from Bani Israel to tell him to say La ilaha illallah. He did not leave any single opportunity, because he wants to be the Prophet where his ummah is the ummah that is marhuna, mercy upon them, where the followers are the people who accepted his call, his message, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not sent illa rahmatan lil alameen. He is mercy to mankind. So this is what led him to strive, his vision. If we look at the basic lifestyle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if we take just some of it, just 5-10% of it, wallahi thumma wallahi, our lives will transform. Our lives will become better. We will become more organized. We will become happier people. There will be more blessings even in your dunya, in your tijara and your work. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is described as our role model. We need to follow him. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. In the Prophet of Allah is the greatest example and role model. For who? لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. For those who want Allah, want to meet him, and those who want the Akhirah, وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا, and those who frequently remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, today scientific research tells us that the most productive time, which surprisingly correlates with the Sunnah, is the mornings after Fajr. If you read the autobiographies of some of the most quote-unquote successful, richest people in the world, they all say we wake up at dawn time. and this is the most productive time. The Prophet ﷺ, he informed us the reason behind this secret. When some of the students that we work with, youngsters, we tell them, study after Fajr, even if it's 1 hour, and see the difference. They say, this 1 hour feels like it was 10 hours. Listen, whatever you do in that, the secret behind that is the Prophet ﷺ said, Ya Allah, bless my ummah in the mornings. Those who wake up early, they will achieve more. And studies today show the attributes of successful people is that they wake up early, they are positive people, and they have clear vision. And the attributes of failures, those who don't get to achieve much, they sleep late and wake up late. They are negative in their outlook, and they have no vision in their life. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Oh Allah, bless my ummah in the mornings. And the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they will send out, when they want to do even tijara, business, they'll send out their caravans in the beginning of the day, and it will return back to them with lots of wealth. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam used to send his armies in the morning. Every single thing we do in the morning will be successful. A recent author and scholar, he wrote a book, The Power of When, Dr. Michael Bruce. He said, the science of good timing, which is something hardwired into our DNA, into our brains, it reveals that the peak performance, the best time for the brain to learn, is also at that time, in the mornings. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا. If we follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we have made the night or your sleep an action that is something that makes you rest. We have made the night dark so that you can rest. And we have made the day bright, full of energy, so that you can get involved in your livelihood. But today, unfortunately, the ummah is in calamity. We sleep extremely late. We hardly wake up for Fajr. When you wake up for Fajr, you pray it so quickly so you can go back to sleep. This is against our fitrah, against our teachings, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam refused to sleep late. It was makruh, it's disliked to sleep late. That between his Isha Salah and sleep was a small gap. After Isha, the companions will never occupy the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The scholars, they said, if it's not for your guests, or for seeking knowledge, or for spending good quality time with your spouse, you shouldn't be up at night. We live in a world where we have to watch a Netflix film or a few YouTube videos until it's 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, and many miss Salat al-Fajr. And this is another secret behind a successful, productive day, Salat al-Fajr. The Prophet said, if you knew the reward of praying the 2 units of prayer before Fajr, not even Fajr, it is better than the dunya and what is in it. And if you know the reward of praying Salat al-Fajr in Jama'ah, you will go to it, not running, walking. You will go there crawling, even if you had no legs. The reward of praying Salat al-Fajr. That Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he said, my nutrition is Fajr. That he will pray Salat al-Fajr, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who prays it in Jama'ah is as if he prayed the whole night. Then he sits and he does the adhkar until the sunrise. He will pray 2 minutes of prayers. It will be like an accepted hajj for him. Imagine someone slept after Isha, 8 p.m. and he woke up for Fajr, 5 a.m. He has time for Qiyam. He will wake up full of energy. 7-8 hours is more than enough sleep. He will pray Fajr. He will do Quran. He can memorize in that time one page at least a day, easily. Within 2 years, he's a hafid of the Quran. He can do his adhkar in the morning. 6:30, he leaves the masjid, and he's extremely active. He's got time for himself. He can read, he can write, he can spend time with the family. He still has 3 hours left before university, college, or work. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about the one who wakes up for Fajr, فَأَصْبَحَ نَشِيطًا طَيِّبَ النَّفْسِ. The one who wakes up for Fajr will wake up active, productive, طيب النفس, and his nafs is in a, such a good mood, good feeling. But the one who misses Fajr, وَإِلَّا أَصْبَحَ خَبِيثَ النَّفْسِ كَسْلَانِ. The reason why we feel like we're tired all the time, we're yawning all the time, no energy, and we're in negative moods, because of Fajr. Wallahi, it's because of Fajr. You can sleep 12 hours, 14 hours, and miss Fajr, no barakah in your day. You will feel tired and lazy for the whole day. But the one who prays Fajr, he'll be طيب النفس. He'll be in a good mood. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he had a vision. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught his companions to be visionary. It was the companions, the likes of Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala an, that gave da'wah all the way to China. The Arabs used to say, as a metaphor, there's a saying, seek knowledge even if you have to go to China. This is a metaphor, it's not real, really, even if you have to go to the moon. It's like us saying, even if you have to go to the moon, because China was so far away. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas went to give da'wah all the way to China. He opened the first masjid in China. The companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum, the Persian Empire, the Roman Empire, all the way to Spain. Within 30, 40 years, Islam spread. This is vision and this is hard work. The scholars of Islam, Imam Bukhari, rahimahullah, he heard his sheikh say, if only there was one person, it would be a wonderful idea if there was someone who can compile all the sahih hadith, who will bring all the authentic hadith into one book. It's an impossible project. Imam Bukhari, he was only 18 years old, he said, I will do this. And he spent 20 years compiling the most authentic book after the Quran, Sahih Bukhari. This is vision and this is action. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم العظيم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. We have three main responsibilities as Muslims. Firstly, the responsibility for our deen. Secondly, the responsibilities for our family. And then lastly, the responsibility towards our community and the ummah. So my advice to myself and my brothers is that we should have a plan, a written document that we have for ourselves. Firstly is our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our deen. How is our deen at the moment and what do we want to, what level do we want to put our deen to? The vision should be that every single one of us want to enter paradise. And the vision should be that we want to save ourselves and our families from the punishment. And we want to live an everlasting life in paradise. So how are we going to do that? This is the global vision of the Muslims. But each one should have an individual vision that will be a token to achieving the bigger vision. So how is our relationship with Allah? And what relationship do we want to have? If your aim is to be a person of paradise, then have some action plan. As the saying says, if you fail to plan, then you plan to fail. And as the Japanese, they say, vision with no action is a daydream. But action with no vision is a nightmare. So we should always follow things up with action. How many salah in jama'ah are we doing? How many sunnah prayers are we praying? Do we try to fast Monday and Thursday? Do we read enough Quran? Do we do our adhkar in the morning and the evening? Do we pray qiyam al-layl? Do we give sadaqah? Do we help our parents? Do we help others? All of this is a group of good deeds that we should write down and we should try to implement if we want to achieve this aim. Secondly, our families. How is our relationship with them? Can it be better? Am I spending enough time? Am I visiting and checking up on my relatives? Cutting the ties of kin is a major sin. How often do I check up on them? And am I working hard to bring them closer to Islam? And then your da'wah, your community, your companions also working towards creating brotherhood with them. And as Allah says, do not forget you're part of the dunya. Study hard, work hard, have itqan even in your careers, and be someone who benefits others. As the Prophet ﷺ said, the best of you are those who are the most beneficial to others. Having a vision, brothers, is something that will help us in all of our decisions that we make. The woman that we marry, the neighborhood that we live in, the job that we take, all of these decisions will be based upon taqwa. Would this make me closer to Allah or further away? And this is why the vision should come first. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he had the greatest balance. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a third of his life was ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكَانُوا لَنَا عَابِدِينَ. And a third of his other life was to his family. He would visit them regularly and look after them. Every single morning he would knock in the house of each one of his wives and not leave until there's happiness in their hearts. The Prophet ﷺ said, the best of you are those who are the best to their families. And despite him being a leader and a prophet, busy with many, many affairs, he spent and invested in his family. And a third of his last life was to his companions, to his followers, to da'wah. This should be the balance we have. Some people are doing da'wah, mashallah, but they neglect their children and their family. And some people, mashallah, they love their wives and children so much that they become a fitna for them because they did not get involved in improving their relationship with Allah and in da'wah.